The BBC has just published a piece stating that online influencers are driving quote-unquote extreme misogyny. Now, in this piece, they focus on Andrew Tate, the influencer popular with young men, and they state that he's essentially an equivalent to a terrorist. The headline of the piece states, "Online influencers like Andrew Tate are radicalizing boys into extreme misogyny in a way that is quite terrifying," police are warning. Good to see the balanced and neutral BBC aren't getting lost in hyperbole or hysteria there. The article continues, stating that Deputy Chief Constable Maggie Blythe said officers who focused on violence against women and girls were now working with counter-terrorism teams to look at the risk of young men being radicalized. Now, I should be honest and state I'm not an expert on Andrew Tate and his exploits, but he does seem to me to be an intelligent, if extremely arrogant and chauvinistic man. That blend can lead Tate to be someone who can be funny, insightful, and willing to tell the harsh truths of life one minute, to someone who's a bit cringy the next, calling himself things like Top G and bragging about how he exploited lonely men by using Russian-Ukrainian models.
Here's maybe this is a bit bad. Here's where the famous would start. So it'd be good. Like, I had a lot of girls who worked for me, and the best was like the Ukrainians or the Russians. It was amazing. Because they'd get some guy, fall in love, da-da-da, they'd arrange the day to meet, all this shit, da-da-da-da. Ah, I need a visa. Okay, get a visa. I need money for a visa. Okay, how much is a visa? It's
Oh my
$900.
God.
No, but it's not $900 because I went to the embassy. They think I'm a risk and I need a return flight there and back and I need a hotel. I need to have spending money in my bank account. They won't let me come. Or how much you need? All right, 10 grand. Boom, 10 G's. Boom. Thanks.
Wow.
Go to the embassy, take a picture outside the embassy, boom, come back. They rejected my visa. They said we have to wait 2 weeks. After 2 weeks, they'll give it to me. Okay, baby, boom. 2 more weeks of tips. Boom, 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 boom. Because now he thinks he's going to f, right? He thinks he's going to get the girls. Now he's spending more than ever. 2 weeks, 2 weeks, 2 weeks. 2 weeks come. Some other problem. Whether it's visa, whatever, whatever. We make up some bullshit, right?
All these OnlyFans chicks can learn from you,
man. Oh, man.
No,
Bro,
but
this
you know
is
what?
Like
I got
a people watching.
Free OnlyFans tutorial
yeah,
here in the DMs.
People would say, why did those girls work for you? Because the girls would work for me. And at 50%, because it was 50-50, would make millions per month. If they worked for themselves, they'd make nothing. I was the best in the game.
Now, I don't know if that is fraudulent or not, but it's certainly unethical ripping off lonely men promising them love for tens of thousands of pounds. But the really funny thing is, if Tate's young male followers saw him in that video, they'd still find a way to defend him. There's an interesting reason as to why that is. People like Andrew Tate, like them or loathe them, represent something to young men. What that is something like meaning, masculine energy, being able to be somebody and something in the world. Remember, these young men have grown up in a world where they've been finger wagged at by bossy HR ladies who just want to condition them into the nuances of feminist theory. Yet since Andrew Tate has gained such fame and adopted Islam, he does seem to have changed his message a little bit. And this is something the BBC aren't very keen on because they want to maintain his image, as that's a very vital node for their own culture war. This is why in the original piece, the BBC describe Andrew Tate as a self-described misogynist, yet you can search his own Twitter and he's recently stated that he's not a misogynist, believing that women should be protected, provided, and cared for.
The feminist narrative is that I'm a controlling man who wants control over women. The actual truth is I'm a protective man who wants to protect. And being a man in a position of protecting is not always a good thing. I feel indebted and have a duty to myself and my honor. Meaning that if I'm walking down the street with a beautiful woman and three men want to attack her, I have to risk my life now. I can't live my life letting my wife get gang raped on a fucking street and running away. I can't take it as a man. So I have to now die.
So what do we make of Andrew Tate and the BBC? Well, firstly, Andrew Tate to me seems like someone whose fame is grown on the back of a hyper-feminized culture. Young men get the message that they have to be soft and weak from such a young age that someone like Andrew Tate seems almost irresistible to them. Yet for those of us who remember the times before the wokeification of the West, we'll remember that the world wasn't always like this. If Andrew Tate acted like he did in a pub in England, say in the 70s or 80s, people would just think he's a bit weird. They'd say, "What are you trying so hard for, Andrew? Like, relax." And that tells us something very important. It was that there was a role of men in the world that was respected at such a time. And in this day and age, it's very much not respected, which means everything's either feminized or taken into some hyper-inflated version of masculinity represented by someone like Andrew Tate. With regards to the BBC, just look at this passage from the original report. The MPCC estimated at least 1 in 12 women in England and Wales would be a victim of violence every year, or about 2 million women. Well, if that's true, that's extremely sad. So many women are facing some sort of domestic violence, but there's no correlation there between that and the behavior of Andrew Tate. So in essence, all they're really doing here is engaging in a hit piece as part of the culture war. They want to present the idea that life is terrifying for women and girls, and that there's bands of young men roaming around behaving absolutely terribly, almost like proto-terrorists. Yet the solution to all this is very simple. You re-establish the role of strong, responsible, and competent men at every level of society. That means at the centre of the family, at schools and universities, and in the workplace and broader culture. If you did that, figures like Andrew Tate would fizzle out in 3 or 4 months. But of course that never happens. Such decent men are always portrayed in our media and culture as evil, toxic boogers, even though they're exactly what we need. And what that leads to is what we have now, a largely feminist takeover of our cultural institutions, our schools, and the family itself. You do have some men in positions of supposed power, but these are usually feminists themselves and are basically just pseudo-women.
You have decided, you know what, I don't like being a man, I don't like my nature, I'm going to go against it and fight with women who hate men.
I don't think that at all. I don't hate being a man.
But you're going against yourself.
I'm going against what a male supremacist society says is my self-interest. But that doesn't even exist.
There's no such thing as a male supremacist society. That's just said in order to control men.
It seems to me that if you really want to stem the excesses of the radical feminists as well as the chauvinist types, you try and adhere to traditional masculine values and virtue. That leads to a stable society and stable families. These are just my views, however. Do let me know what you think down below, and do consider subscribing to the channel.